stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayatins. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Stay away from the major sins. Ignore the whispers of the shayatins. Oh Lord, have mercy on our souls. Oh Lord, have mercy.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All the praise and all the glory is due to Allah, and I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is His last prophet and messenger. May the blessings and peace of Allah be upon our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, his family, his companions, and those who followed his path up to the day of judgment. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, nobody can lead astray. And whomever Allah leads astray can never be guided. And he is the one full of wisdom, full of awareness of all what his slaves do. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we continue talking about healing hearts, or topics which are related to the tendering of our hearts and healing the diseases which have been stuffed on our hearts like layers. So it tried actually to make a barrier between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a barrier between true guidance and our hearts. I remind you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pointed to the significance of fixing and purifying one's heart, because it is the basic element in the whole body upon which all the acts of worship rely. And this is the abode, or is the home, for all mercy and tranquility and iman. And this is a place for the insinuations of the shaitan and the inspiration of Ar-Rahman, the Most Merciful. In today's session, we are talking about a station that the heart must pass through, which is called gratefulness or ash-shukr. The heart must have a feeling of shukr, a feeling of being grateful to the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. The scholars actually talked about the meaning of shukr in that sense. It is a sense of praising the benevolent or the giver of a blessing or the blesser, and admitting of his blessing and submission to him and praising him for what he has given, and also making all optimum effort and spending all possible effort to please him and to use this blessing in his pleasure. So again, the meaning of gratefulness or being grateful is that you admit of the blessings showered upon you, try to use them in the best way to please the one who showered them on you, and actually to see him very clearly in every single step and in every single inch of that blessing. And you are not preoccupied with that blessing being turned away from the greatest one who bestowed, who has given you those gifts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the source of all blessings, and he is the one who bestowed on the sons of Adam his blessings by day and night. And without Allah, I am nothing. And without Allah, you are nothing. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatever a blessing that you have in yourselves, it's only from Allah, the main source of goodness and the main source of giving. It is Allah. That's why he is called, he is Al-Khaliq, the Creator. He is the one who manages the affairs of his servants, the provider and the true sustainer and responsible for the universe. Shukr or gratefulness is related to the heart, and it's related to the apparent senses also, or the apparent organs of the body. For the heart, it must have a full sense of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the tongue, is to mention that, to translate it by saying Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, the tongue itself admits that it is He who has given those gifts to you. And finally, you must utilize those blessings in the way that He has drawn for you, in the way which is allowed, in the way that pleases Him. And you don't try to misuse any of His givings, any of His gifts, in fighting against Him. Because we find a lot of people that they are endowed with sight, but they use these eyes for fighting against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. They are endowed with hearing, and they use it to hear bad things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them hands and feet, and they use it for the disobedience of Allah. And it's actually against the sense or the quality of gratefulness. And the best type of shukr is the shukr of the heart. The best type of gratefulness is it in the heart. It's not only in the tongue, because we find a lot of people, they just hymn the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you see him and you say, how are things with you? And he says, Alhamdulillah. He says, Alhamdulillah with his tongue. But when it goes to himself and in his family and his life, he does not express that type of hamd, because he is displeased with what Allah has given him. He is displeased with everything. He is complaining, keep complaining about everything. So he actually did not achieve that internally. So it is a type of what you can call hypocrisy. A person showing something, but internally it is the opposite. And this is actually one of the problems that we have. We must have a compatibility between our hearts and our tongues. When the tongue expresses pleasure about Allah's blessings, we need also to submit the same heart for this. And also, the best type of shukr or praise or being grateful is not to concentrate on the blessing. You must not let that blessing turn you away from the greatest one who gave it to you. A lot of people, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for favors. They ask Allah in their dua. For example, somebody is asking for a righteous wife, or she is asking for a righteous husband. But with the process of time, Allah gives her to him, whatever. And then with the process, they become attached to each other. And she concentrates on that blessing, and he concentrates on that blessing. They forget the great blesser, who's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they are turned away from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained that in the Quran. هو الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها زوجها ليسكن إليها. It is the one who created you from a single soul. And he created from this soul its spouse to return to him in tranquility. فلما تغشاها, when he had intimacy with her, she became pregnant. فلما تغشاها حملت حملا خفيفا, and she became lightly pregnant, so it was an easy pregnancy. And then she gave delivery. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us an example. حملت حملا خفيفا فمرت به. فلما, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them the baby, and they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them with the baby, afterwards they made it as a part, or they associated that baby in the love that they had for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a type of association, and not only in submission but in love. The attachment, a lot of people, they are mostly attached to the dunya. And they forget who is the one who gave you this dunya, who is the one who gave all of this life, who is the one who gave you all those blessings by day and night that are being showered on you. So one of the important, significant points is, do not let the blessing itself drive you away from turning away or pointing or paying attention to the greatest giver, to the greatest one. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the important things about shukr also, that every single thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to anybody, He gave him also a key of how to get increase of it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave keys for the increase of the benefits or the blessings that He gives. He says in the Quran, وَإِسْتَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. And remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you in my blessings. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases the blessings by shukr. So the key of increase is shukr, is to be grateful to Allah, to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was passed by a Jew and he was sitting in humbleness, and the Jew said to the people, he said, look at him, he is sitting like a slave. So he's underestimating the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he heard him, he said, and who is more worthy to be a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than me? He is admitting that he is the slave of Allah. He is actually submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he loves him. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ أَحَدَكُمْ يَأْكُلُ الْأَكْلَةَ فَيَحْمَدُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surely loves the one when he eats something, when he gets a meal, he praises Allah for it. And when he drinks something, he praises Allah for it. You cannot imagine, this is a tiny and little thing, that when you actually eat a meal or you get a piece of bread and then you say Alhamdulillah, you say praise be to Allah. This is something which is highly praised and highly estimated in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a means of increasing. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made shukr actually as a necessity in the hadith of the Prophet, which is very well known. كُلُّ سُلَامَا مِنَ النَّاسِ عَلَيْهِ صَدَقَةً. Each person's joints is supposed to be praised by giving a charity. So the scholar said that how many joints that a person has in his body? They said that they are 360. So a person is supposed to give a charity for every single organ or joint that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in his body. So he's supposed to make 360 acts of a charity per day. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us examples of those charities. When you give help for somebody to mount his, what you can call his belongings on his ride, helping somebody in his car, for example, or when you remove a harmful thing from the way of people, when you smile in the face of your brother, whenever you give somebody a charity or money or whatever, all of those are types of charity. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you don't have to do all of this, because it is only two raka'ats of Salatul Duha, two raka'ats of the prayer of Al-Duha are actually enough to express your gratefulness. We will talk about it and we will elaborate this hadith a little bit after having this short break. So stay with us and we will be back very soon. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam initiated that every single person has to pay those 360 acts of charity. But it can be all fulfilled, and this is out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through the two raka'ats that a person performs before the zuhr or the noon time. And this is called Salatul Duha. Salatul Duha is very important to make an act of charity before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a matter of gratefulness. And the scholars said that that's why gratefulness, or being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not only highly recommended, but it's obligatory. You have to express that type of gratefulness. And the scholars talked about the grades of shukr. There are grades of shukr that a person experiences throughout the station of that heart. Number one, ash-shukru ala al-mahab. When a person expresses his gratefulness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of whatever things that he showered on him, and those are of the beloved things, like for example the ni'am, the blessings, like sighting, hearing, sons and daughters, wife, villas, places, houses, cars, of all those belongs health, iman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to him, Islam, to become a Muslim. And all of those talents, when a person actually thinks about them, he must be actually grateful. This is things which are beloved to the person. And number two, there is a type, or there is a grade of shukr. When a person is afflicted with a trial or a tribulation, he's supposed also to praise Allah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who is praised in all situations, either in time of ease or happiness, or in times of difficulty. Alhamdulillah alladhi la yuhmadu ala makruhin siwa. Praise be to Allah, the one who is praised, and nobody is praised for a difficulty except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a person is supposed to be grateful to Allah that he has not, subhanahu wa ta'ala, made it a greater problem for him. Number two, expecting the reward from Allah. And this is the reason that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave examples of how a person is supposed to say Alhamdulillah when he is stricken with a problem. According to the authentic hadith, that when a person has one of his dear ones or friends or relatives being died, Allah sends angels and to see what is he saying. And then he is asking those angels, what did my slave say? And they say, he said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, to Allah we belong and to Allah is the final return. And then he says, build a palace for my slave in the Jannah and call it the palace of Hamd, the palace of Shukr, the palace of praise or being grateful. And the third type of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a person preoccupies his heart with the original of all those blessings, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he stands upon the lines of the worshippers by day and night, turning his face to him and directing all of his intentions and sincerity and dedication to him. So he becomes a dedicated and devoted slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the depths of the night or in the daybreak. Wherever and whenever Allah looks at him, he finds him in an act of worship, turning away, turning in those grades of highness. That's why if you would like to know your real position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look, where did he put you? Did he put you with the people in masajids and you are occupied with salah prayers here and there, giving charity, helping people, fasting, going to Hajj and Umrah every time? Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you with the criminals? He put you with the people who commit mistakes, people who commit and make sins. It is according to the position and the situation Allah puts you in, you make sure whether you are actually beloved to him or not. So we have three basic grades of hamd. The first grade, which is praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for things beloved to you and he has given to you. Number two, praising Allah in times of difficulties. And number three, preoccupying the whole heart with shukr and gratefulness. And this is the situation of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But anyhow, there is some meanings that a person, when he praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, should put in his heart. Number one, a person should actually represent in his heart a sense of shyness from Allah. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given and cared about him by day and night, and he is still not fulfilling the minimum requirements of standing and praying and making his due rights towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yet he's still forgiving. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when his wives saw his feet being swollen and the blood is being shed and he's standing in the depths of the night in just two raka'at, and then one of his wives is asking him, Allah has forgiven all of your sins, why you shouldn't take rest? Because we understand when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me salvation and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven me, so I don't need to work. No, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood it in another meaning, which is if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me all of those blessings, I am supposed to be more grateful to him, to show more praise to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the type of haya or shyness or modesty that a person retains in his heart when he expresses shukr to Allah. When a person actually makes a shukr, he must admit that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is most worthy of being praised. And nobody on the face of the earth is more worthy to be praised but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need also to understand that when Allah helped you and inclined or inspired you to make shukr to him, praise to him, it is a blessing itself. When you say Alhamdulillah, this Alhamdulillah needs another statement of Alhamdulillah, because it is the one who helped you to say it. It is the one who helped you to teach you how to praise him. It is the one who gave you the blessings of a tongue to pronounce this type of Alhamdulillah. So saying Alhamdulillah by itself needs another act of praise to fulfill the duties due on you. Also, a person should quit showing displeasure on whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to him. And whenever he is given anything, he must actually be receptive, receive it, and being pleased with it. I still remember the story of Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, may Allah be pleased with him. And this is a higher grade of what you can call not sabr. It is not shukr, but it's rida. It is not praise, it is not patience, but it's a higher grade which is called al-rida. Being completely content with what Allah has given to you. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, according to the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, he was given the point of having an accepted dua or supplication. Whenever he raises his hands, Allah accepts his supplication. And there are numerous ahadiths which he talks about occasions where Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas raised his hands and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his invocations. At the end of his life, he had actually lost his sight and he became blind. So the people were insisting on him and saying, why you don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to regain or to retain your sight again? And he says, can you imagine? What did he say? He says, the qadr of Allah, the divine decree of Allah, is better and more beloved to me than my own eyes. Subhanallah, a person choosing to be sightless, and this is a meaning we cannot actually comprehend, cannot understand, that it is more beloved to him to get and to pick up the choice of Allah than to get his own sight. He remained sightless throughout the rest of his life, basically of that rida. Listen to the Prophet ﷺ, he was the best one to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to express it from the very first second that he gets up early in the morning, when the Prophet ﷺ says, Alhamdulillah الذي أحياني بعدما أمتني. Praise be to Allah, the one who gave me life after I have been dead. Because when a person sleeps, he is in a state of death or a minor death. And the Prophet ﷺ, the first words he says in his sujood, in Qiyamul Layl, he says, Allahumma laka alhamd. O Allah, to you belongs all praise. You are the light of the heavens and the earth. To you belongs all the praise. You are the one who manages the affairs of the heavens and the earth. You are the creator of the heavens and the earth. Your promises is truth. Your words are truth. Your prophet is the truth. And your meeting in the final resurrection day is the truth. Prophet ﷺ was the best praisers of people who are grateful. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among ash-shakirin, to make us among the grateful who stabilize their hearts on praise and love and pleasure for Allah and with Allah. Wa sallallahumma ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
Stay away from the major sins, ignore the whispers of the shade.